double-decker bus is a home, and it's truly extraordinary. When one family bought a double-decker bus for their vacation vehicle, the decision no doubt raised a few eyebrows. However, when you get a glimpse inside the finished article, you realize how truly magical it actually is. Andrew and Lisa Jane Powis live in a small rural plot of land called Pigeon Door in Wrighton in the county of Shropshire, England. Together, the couple have three children, Charles, Clara, and George. Their two beloved Great Danes complete the family unit. In 2015, Andrew and Lisa Jane's brood were growing up fast. Eldest child Charles was already 13, his sister Clara was 7, and little George was 4. Like many families, the Powis clan were keen to make as many memories with their children as possible. One way the family enjoyed spending special time together was by taking breaks away. However, they often had trouble finding suitable accommodation. That's because many holiday cottages they contacted refused to accept their two gigantic dogs. The lack of options forced the family to consider caravan holidays. However, these weren't very practical either. Standing at 6'5", Andrew was anything but small, and spending lots of time cramped up in a caravan was not very comfortable. "I'd struggle alone in a caravan, let alone with three kids and two Great Danes charging about," Andrew explained to the Daily Mail in 2015. "A lot of holiday cottages are pretty doggone friendly, too. We always found it really tough to find somewhere that would have us." In the end, the family decided to take matters into their own hands. They decided to invest in their own motorhome. However, rather than purchasing an off-the-peg model, they instead opted for a unique approach. Andrew and Lisa Jane splashed out roughly $3,300, or £2,500, on a vintage Leyland Atlantean bus on eBay. At the time, the vehicle still very much resembled a form of public transport. However, with hard work and lots of imagination, the bus was reborn as something astonishing. "We thought, why not build our own supersized caravan?" Andrew said, explaining the reasoning behind the seemingly bizarre decision to purchase a vehicle never intended to be used as accommodation. "We thought we'd give it a go, and it really worked out." Lisa Jane revealed that the renovation did take them out of their comfort zone. "We didn't have any experience with this sort of thing," she admitted, "but as Andrew's a farmer, he's pretty practical, so we just kind of worked it out as we went along." First, all the rows of seating on the lower deck were dispensed with to make space for a fully equipped kitchen, a seating area, and a bathroom. On the upper deck, the family installed three bedrooms, a double, a single, and two bunk beds, all of them naturally boasting fantastic views. Over the course of 6 weeks, the Powis family spent about $20,000, or £15,000, converting the bus to living accommodation of the highest standard. They ensured that the vehicle contained every mod con it possibly could, installing Wi-Fi, a television, and a DVD player. Furthermore, to ensure the bus was comfortable all year, Andrew and Lisa Jane fitted a heating system and real flame effect stove. When they had completed the conversion project, they lovingly renamed the bus Betsy Blue. However, that's when their dreams of a mobile home from home hit a slight hitch. The work on Betsy had been so extensive that the family discovered keeping it mobile was no longer a plausible option. Determined all their hard work would not be wasted, however, they came up with an ingenious plan to ensure they and others could enjoy the bus after all. Instead, the five-berth bus became a permanent fixture on their Shropshire small holding. Now, from about $160 or £120 per night, guests can snuggle up in Betsy Blue for one of the most unusual holiday experiences around. At no extra cost, visitors also have access to their own hot tub situated just outside. Although the outcome was not what was originally intended, the Powis family were proud of their achievement. "The kids absolutely love it," Andrew told the Daily Mail. "They hoped it was just for us. I think they're a bit gutted that we keep running it out." Despite the Powis children's trepidation, Betsy pressed her first guests. "The feedback has been amazing," Lisa Jane revealed back in 2015, "because there's loads of space. Little things like the hot tub and the log burner make a big impression too." In the end, Betsy Blue proved so popular that Lisa Jane quit her job as a school induction manager to take care of the holiday home venture full-time. The Powis family has since expanded their fleet of converted buses to include two six-berth vehicles called Billy and Beatty. The buses have enjoyed glowing reviews on the Glamping site's Facebook page. "What a holiday. We couldn't believe how relaxing the experience was, and we really loved the hot tub," read one from 2017. Lisa Jane and Andrew were the perfect hosts, super helpful and welcoming, it added. The Powis family are just overjoyed that they can share their passion with the paying public. We were not expecting the success we had, Lisa Jane admitted to the Shropshire Star in 2015. With Andrew working as a farmer, it was quite stressful and tiring at times, but the results have been very rewarding. Share this video with your friends.